In this video, I'm going to talk about the advantages and disadvantages of using price action analysis versus the institutional trading methodologies that will be revealed here in the channel in a few months. Some people have asked me to talk about that since there is a lot of mystery regarding these ideas, especially around institutional trading. Most people don't know how banks and funds act in the financial markets and why they act too. Most traders believe that the primordial goal in the financial market is to make money. That's not necessarily true for a bank, for example. Without further ado, let's get right into the topic of this video. I will analyze both methods using several perspectives to compare them. Let's first talk about the level of difficulty in learning both methods. Price action analysis is relatively easy to learn, even though the type of price action analysis I teach here is a little denser than the one you will find online in most cases. Even though I wouldn't say that my methods are necessarily the easiest thing to learn, you're still not required to learn complex mathematics and statistics. With professional price action methods, we can sort of stay on the surface of these topics and only worry about the raw intuition behind them. In other words, there is no need for you to grasp difficult and cumulative mathematical concepts. With institutional trading methods, you absolutely must apprehend difficult mathematical and statistical ideas, otherwise you will simply not understand what you're doing, and that's obviously dangerous. There's a lot of mathematics involved in the methodologies used by a bank, for example, and I will get into that in a moment. So in summary, price action is relatively easy to learn in comparison to institutional trading methods. Moving on to the second parameter, which relates to the difficulty of application of these methods, the first thing that comes to mind is that there is a lot of nuance here. The application of price action methods is certainly more difficult than learning it because we have to deal with behavioral economics in a more explicit way, so to speak, and the chart is, at the end of the day, a rather limited source of information. That means that extracting a lot of valuable information from historical prices is possible, but it's not an easy thing to do. Unfortunately, this process never gets easier because its nature is complicated. It's always difficult to build a comprehensive price action analysis. In institutional trading methods, things are much easier in this regard. Once you understand the mathematics behind the trades, they are surprisingly simple to put into practice. The good thing about relying more heavily on mathematics is that it does most of the job for you, meaning that the sophisticated mathematical ideas that sustain the institutional trading methods do most of the heavy lifting in the analysis, which is a great relief. Notice that price action trading and institutional trading are kind of the opposite of one another. Price action trading is relatively easy to learn, but it's a little more difficult to apply. Institutional trading is difficult to learn, but is theoretically easy to apply with a few exceptions that I will explain in a moment. To make an analogy, using price action is like living in an average apartment in a big city. A lot of people do it, but it's a constant struggle. Institutional trading is like living on a mansion on top of Mount Everest. It's great once you get there, but first you must climb the highest mountain on the planet. In terms of the scientific backbone of both methods, price action analysis, at least in the way I teach here, has a significant degree of scientific substance behind it, which I can say that doesn't happen in a lot of methodologies you see out there. The scientific starting point for my price action methods is similar to the starting point of the institutional trading methods, like the connection between physics and finance, for example. With that said, the science contained in the institutional trading methods is much higher. There's just no question about that because these methods are the end result of hundreds of years of deep scientific discoveries, a few Nobel Prizes, and so on. Think about institutional trading methods as the highest peak you can achieve in finance. In terms of accessibility, price action trading is a winner because nowadays, finding a broker that offers you a platform that allows you to observe a price chart and trade through it is the easiest thing in the world. For institutional trading methods, the story is a lot different. It's relatively easy to find a broker that allows you to trade derivatives, for example, but these brokers usually don't offer the complete tools for you to analyze the markets, and you have to go after other third-party services that allow you to do that. in the institutional realm, it's not uncommon for people to develop their own analytical tools. That's a disadvantage, obviously, but if you can do that, you'll be far ahead of the herd. In terms of operational barriers, price action methods are much easier also. That's because if you trade with charts, you can find liquidity in many places and the operational costs are relatively low. For institutional trading methods, depending on which country you're at, you will have liquidity problems with some types of strategies, and then you have to employ other types of strategies to get around that problem. There are a few types of institutional strategies that you need fast execution algorithms too, because if you try to do it manually, you will completely screw it up. Another operational barrier in institutional trading is that depending on the size of your operations, you need to slice them in several smaller trades, and that also requires a fast algorithm. It's important to say that an execution algorithm is different than an analytical algorithm. In terms of risk, price action and institutional trading strategies are a bit different. A price action trader has the goal of making money through speculation. There is no other possible goal there. A bank, on the other hand, can use institutional strategies for speculation, hedging, and arbitrage, but mainly for hedging. In other words, a bank is mainly interested in hedging its credit operations in the financial markets. A bank doesn't make money in the markets, it makes money by lending money to other people. Since credit operations have a lot of risk, banks need to mitigate that risk somehow. They do that by hedging these credit operations in the derivatives market. The important point here is that a normal person can use hedging operations to make money. That's what most people don't realize. Hedging operations are much safer than speculative operations because, as the name suggests, these operations hedge several types of risks in the market, especially the directional risk, which is a big deal. Most price action traders don't even dream about removing directional risk. What I mean by that is that in terms of risk minimization and reward maximization, institutional strategies are better than price action ones due to the heavy mathematical apparatus behind them that allows traders to hedge several types of risk simultaneously. The last parameter is the goals you can have with each method. With price action trading, you can only speculate in the market. With institutional trading techniques, you can speculate, arbitrage, and hedge too. So there is a wider range of possibilities. As you can see, both methods have advantages and disadvantages. It's a matter of what suits your personality best and how you deal with risk that is going to determine which path you're going to take. So that's it for this video. If you wish to learn the best price action trading strategies on the market today, please check out the courses available in the video description. If you wish to support the channel, please click the like button, subscribe to the channel, and leave your comment below. Thank you for watching. Take care.